We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Holy and gracious God, I confess that I have sinned against you. Some of my sin I know, the thoughts and words and deeds of which I am ashamed, but some is known only to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I ask forgiveness. Deliver and restore me, that I may go forth in peace. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Everlasting God, you have wonderfully established the ministries of angels and mortals. Mercifully grant that as Michael and the angels contend against the cosmic forces of evil, so by your direction they may help and defend us here on earth. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, whom we worship and praise with angels and archangels, and all the company of heaven, now and forever. Amen.
Me and roused me to my hands and knees. He said to me, Daniel, greatly beloved, pay attention to the words that I am going to speak to you. Stand on your feet, for I have now been sent to you. So while he was speaking this word to me, I stood up, trembling. He said to me, do not fear, Daniel, for from the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and to humble yourself before your God, your words have been heard, and I have come because of your words. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia opposed me 21 days. So Michael, one of the chief priests, came to help me, and I left him there with the prince of the kingdom of Persia, and have come to help you understand what is to happen to your people at the end of days. For there is further vision for those days. At that time, Michael, the great prince, the protector of your people, shall arise. There shall be time of anguish, such as never occurred since nations first came into existence. But at that time, your people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the sky, and those who lead many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
God's holy name.
Bless the Lord, O my soul,
and forget not all God's benefits, who forgives all your sins and heals all your diseases,
who redeems your life from the grave
and crowns you with steadfast love and mercy, who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like an eagle's.
Bless the Lord, you angels, you mighty ones who do God's bidding, and obey the voice of God's word.
Bless the Lord, all you host of God, you servants who do God's will.
Bless the Lord, all you serve God, in all places where God rules. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord.
Of God.
A reading from Revelation. War broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent, who is called the devil and Satan. That's the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, "Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our comrades has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. But they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they did not cling to life even in the face of death. Rejoice then, you heavens and those who dwell in them, but woe to the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you with great wrath, because he knows that his time is short." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to Luke, the 10th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 70 returned with joy, saying, "Lord, in your name, even the demons submit to us." He said to them, "I watched Satan fall from heaven like a flash of lightning. See, I have given you authority to tread on snakes and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing will hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice at this, that the spirits submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you,
O Christ. You may be seated. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Today, my friends, is our church's festival of Saint Michael and all angels, or as popularly also called, Saint Michaelmas. The one day on the church year calendar that honors the angels of God. Or more accurately, that Sunday that thanks God for the angels. But who are God's angels? And more importantly, what should they mean to us today? When most people deny their very existence and laugh at all this angel talk that we heard in this morning's Bible readings. Well, first of all, it helps to recognize that much of what you and I envision about angels comes from our pious traditions rather than from the Bible. The Bible tells us surprisingly little about angels. We simply run into angels all over the Bible. From Genesis, where God assigns an angel to guard the gate to the Garden of Eden, all the way to the end, to Revelation, where God's angels wage a mighty war against the devil and all his evil forces. Our knowledge of angels, therefore, at least in terms of biblical knowledge, does not come from any neat, precise definitions, but rather from watching angels in action. The only thing close to a definition of angels in the Bible is one verse in the New Testament letter to the Hebrews. Are not all angels spirits in the service of God, sent to serve for the sake of those who are to inherit salvation? Again, are not all angels spirits in the service of God, sent to serve for the sake of those who are to inherit salvation? So, angels are spirits. Their purpose is to serve God, and God uses their service by having them serve us. Now, we, of course, have all kinds of personal images of angels, don't we? Most of them probably come from our childhood in Sunday school. For example, all those wings and halos from countless Christmas pageants. Well, let's remember from that Hebrews verse, angels are spirits, meaning that they don't have any given form or appearance, even though people see them in the Bible in many, many different forms, from mighty armored warriors to six-winged creatures flying around the throne of God and bowing over the Ark of the Covenant, to white-robed men sitting outside an empty tomb one morning with the rather amazing message, "He's not here, he is risen." Actually, there are 9 different kinds of angels mentioned in the scripture. Did you know that? 9. Seraphim, cherubim, thrones, dominions, princedoms, powers, angels, archangels, and virtues. As the quote from Hebrews tells us, the primary reason all these heavenly creatures are mentioned is to show them serving God. And they seem to do that in 4 different ways. First of all, angels simply praise God. Secondly, angels serve God by doing battle against the forces of evil. Thirdly, angels serve God by being God's messengers to us. And finally, angels serve God and us by protecting us from harm and danger. None of these things that the angels do, however, changes just because many folks today don't even believe they exist. They're still there, serving God and us. Let me give you an example of how we use the message, the biblical message of angels. Trying to figure out how the battle between Saint Michael and Satan in today's second reading, trying to figure out how that happened, or even when and if it happened historically. Trying to figure that out is really immaterial, isn't it? What really matters, as far as the Bible is concerned, is the message that God's angels are here on our side in all of our struggles with temptation and evil every day. It's really immaterial how the angels protect us or what they might look like while they're doing it. What's important is the Bible's promise that they do. I believe that as Christians, all of us would agree that we are called, like the angels, to praise and serve God. A God of grace who in Jesus Christ crucified and risen forgives us, grants us the gift of eternal life and salvation. We'd also agree, I believe, that just like the angels, you and I are called to serve one another and our neighbors in God's name. To put it simply, God sends the angels to assist us, to help us in our calling. We don't know exactly how they do it. We seldom recognize them doing it. But we do know, I trust, that we need all the help we can get. You know, when you and I are left on our own, we have a frightening capacity to just forget about God. On our own, we are very good at ignoring Jesus' call that we share his love and blessings with one another and our neighbor. Over and over again, my friends, for Jesus' sake, God affirms our forgiveness. Over and over again, God restores you and me to the family of God. This is what we call the gospel, the good news of what God is doing. Well, God's angels are a part of this good news. They're one of God's many gifts of love to us. And they're far from the least important of the gifts we receive, even though we don't often think of them or acknowledge them. So today, on this festival of Saint Michael and All Angels, you and I are reminded to not simply remember the angels once in a while, but to take a look at our own faith and life. We're reminded today to ask ourselves, how are we using God's gift of the angels? Do we trust God's promise of their presence among us? Are we listening for the messages God's sending to us through the angels? Do we give thanks in our prayers for the angels' help and protection? Now, of course, we do not worship the angels. They're not little gods or some divine beings. They're God's creatures, as you and I are. You and I are here today to worship God, as we are every time we gather together in Jesus' name. But as we thank and praise God today, we include in our thanks all of those angels who are serving God. We give thanks for all of those angels who are standing ready and eager to help us do the same. So we say to God today, thank you. Thank you for those special creatures we know as your holy angels, by whom you love us and care for us. Whether you and I think of angels as Michael the mighty warrior, or as Gabriel, God's great messenger, or as the cherubim and seraphim gathered around the heavenly throne of God, as the prophet Isaiah saw the angels, or if you simply think of the angels as that guardian angel who's been watching over you throughout your life. Yes, my friends, however our faith sees angels, we praise God today for the biblical promise that they are indeed with us. Again, thanks and praise to God. For Saint Michael and all the angels, God grant to each and every one of us a faith that recognizes them in our lives, the faith to recognize the gentle, personal, protecting, guiding touch of these powerful allies. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now may the peace of God that passes all our human understanding keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus to life everlasting. Amen.
God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess what we believe. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Trusting in the goodness of God, let us pray for the church, the world, and one another. Holy Lord, holy and almighty, holy and immortal, heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Angels and archangels, cherubim and seraphim adore you in unceasing chorus. Thank you for their ministry that glorifies you and protects, defends, and sanctifies us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give your church the voice and the faith to join the angels in serving and adoring you. Make its worship a foretaste of heaven. Make its proclamation a strong witness to the lordship of Jesus Christ. Make its deeds of charity a countersign to the devil and all his empty promises. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless this congregation and make it rich in faith toward you and in fervent love for one another. Help us to be as merciful and gracious to all others as you have been toward us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the flourishing of all that you have made, for the birds and squirrels, spiders and whales, oak trees and humble grasses. Renew prairies and forests, tundras and wetlands, that they sustain all who make their home there. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the peoples of the world and for their leaders, where conflict and violence reign, bring peace. Where there is oppression or discrimination, bring liberation. Guide us in power to protect those who are most vulnerable. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray on behalf of everyone who cries out to you for help in time of trouble or suffering, especially Jan, Rosemarie, Eleanor, Jewel, Charlie, Ed, Carolyn, Pastor Joe, Ilga, Paige, Tom, Helga, Jeffrey, Guy, Bill, Allison, Tony, Jack, Don, Hans, Manuel, Dixie, Max, Felicia, Franz, Ryan, Pam, Donna, Josiah, Ed, Charlie, Dave, Gordon, Doug, Denise, Jim, Luca, Liana, Dee Dee, Aaliyah, Jose, Dwight, Ariana, Roxanne, Terry, Mirley, Anish, Nathan, John, Kyle, Marianne, Dan, Frank, Grace, Kat, Olivia, Ava, Mary, Keith, Heather, Aquino, the Salcod family, and all families who were affected by the southern hurricane. Speedily rescue them from affliction. Stir up compassion and gentleness in all who care for them. Let your holy angels have charge of them, that the wicked one have no power over them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we offer to you our praise and thanksgiving for answering our prayers from your grace and love. For all your good gifts, O God, we give you thanks.
Thanks be to God.
We offer thanksgiving for our beloved dead, especially Jane. At the close of our earthly pilgrimage, gather us with Michael and all the saints and angels into everlasting life in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Also with you.
Let us share a sign of that peace with one another. Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
The choir will actually be singing a version of Be Thou My Vision, an ancient Irish tune and text, Be Thou My Vision.
Thank you.
By these gifts and with our lives, help us to serve one another and all in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. God, our bread of life, our table and our food. You created a world in which all might be satisfied by your abundance. You dined with Abraham and Sarah, promising them life, and fed your people Israel with manna from heaven. You sent your son to eat with sinners and to become food for the world. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, blessed it, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup, blessed it, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his life given for us, his rising from the grave, we await his coming again to share with us the everlasting feast. By your Spirit, nurture and sustain us with this meal. Strengthen us to serve all in hunger and want. And by this bread and cup, make of us the body of your Son. Through him, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church, both now and forever. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus says, "Whoever comes to me shall not hunger, and whoever believes in me shall never thirst." Lord, give us this bread always.
Take away my sin.
If those of you who have not received the sacrament would like to join me in the prayer in the absence of communion. Lord Jesus Christ, you are the bread of life and the cup of salvation. I believe that you are truly present in the sacrament of Holy Communion. I am baptized into your death and resurrection. I seek you daily in worship and adore you. Since I cannot receive you in the Eucharistic bread and wine, I pray that you continue to come into my heart and soul as you always have, through confession and forgiveness, through the proclamation of your holy word, and through the prayers of your people, that I may remain united to you by your all-powerful and ever-present Holy Spirit. Let me receive you and be nourished by your abundant grace. Be for me the manna in my wilderness, the bread of angels for my very human journey through time, a foretaste of the heavenly banquet, and solace in the hour of my death. I pray all this, trusting that you are my life, my peace, and my everlasting joy. Amen. Amen. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Holy God, you have welcomed us to this meal and fed us with dignity at your table. Send us now to welcome others and to be at peace with one another. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Just a couple of announcements. Bible study, Ray is still returning tonight, or you're not sure?
How many people are sick? Oh, not here.
Okay, yes, I won't be there. So is that a no, we're not going to do?
No.
No. Okay, so no Bible study tonight. We'll start that next week. If you have not yet returned your Pulse questionnaire, please do so. If you don't have one, there are some blank ones up by the Pulse box, so if you could please fill those out. Carol's Closet is in need of some items. They're listed in your bulletin, and it's time for us to update our prayer list. So if you have a name that you want to remain on the prayer list and it's already on there, circle it. If it's not on there, write it on there and circle it. If there is a name that is on there that we can take off, please just put a line through it. And Dottie will start with a new one next week. And you know, if it doesn't get on, then add it on after that. But we're gonna start over because we have a numbers that are crossed off and stuff. Other announcements. No announcements. Whew. Okay. Then let us bow our heads for the blessing. God Almighty, God most merciful, bless you and keep you and give you peace. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
in peace to love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you.